전 세계 비영리 비당파 독립 언론을 소개하는 연속 기획 두 번째 시간입니다. 한국에서는 정부나 대기업의 입장에 반하는 보도를 하는 언론인들이 해고를 당하는 경우가 있습니다만 외국에서는 아예 납치되거나 살해되는 경우도 많습니다. 동유럽이나 중앙아시아도 그런 곳인데요. 동유럽과 중앙아시아의 독립 탐사보도 매체들이 조직 범죄와 마약 등 매우 위험한 취재를 하기 위해 서로 돕는 공조 취재 네트워크를 만들어 활동하고 있습니다. OCCRP, 즉 조직 범죄와 부패 보도 프로젝트를 이끌고 있는 폴 라두 대표를 이유정 기자가 만났습니다.
루마니아의 수도 부쿠레스티. 동유럽과 중앙아시아 독립 탐사 매체들의 네트워크인 OCCRP, 즉 조직 범죄와 부패 보도 프로젝트가 있는 곳입니다. 2007년 출범한 OCCRP는 150명이 넘는 기자들이 국경을 넘나드는 부패와 조직 범죄에 대응해 국제 공조 취재를 펼치고 있습니다. 주요 취재 영역은 마약이나 인신매매, 무기 밀거래, 정치 자금 세탁 등입니다. 현재 OCCRP를 이끌고 있는 사람은 루마니아 기자 폴 라두입니다.
We are investigating organized crime and corruption. And there's no high-level local organized crime, and there's no high-level local corruption. Whenever, let's say, a politician from a government in Eastern Europe would get a bribe, would cash in a bribe, they would cash it in such a way that it would go to an offshore bank account, it would go through a myriad of companies, so it would be quite complex schemes. So in order to investigate such schemes, you need to cooperate with colleagues in other countries.
자본과 권력의 입김에 취약한 동유럽 언론 환경도 OCCRP 설립에 큰 이유가 됐습니다. 주요 언론사의 소유주가 명확하게 공개되지 않아 수용자들은 뉴스 생산자가 누구인지 파악하기 어렵습니다. 언론 소유주의 이해관계에 따라 뉴스가 악용되기 쉬운 구조인 것입니다. 언론이 권력의 도구로 이용되는 경우도 흔합니다.
Because lots of these media outlets are not doing a public service. They're not in the service of the public. They are in the service of the owner. And let's say whenever the owner has some problems with justice, you know, the prosecution starts a case against them for money laundering, for corruption. That moment they start using their media outlets to attack, you know, the judges, to attack whoever, or to attack their business opponents, or to blackmail them. So this happens quite often. So this is why an organization like OCCRP, but especially the centers that make OCCRP, are very important because we are covering what the others are not covering.
OCCRP의 공조 취재는 여러 굵직한 폭로 보도를 이끌어냈습니다. 실각된 우크라이나 야누코비치 대통령이 도주하면서 숨기거나 폐기한 비밀 문서를 추적, 조사하는 야누코비치 리크스. OCCRP는 현지 기자들과 함께 야누코비치가 사저 인공호수에 폐기한 방대한 양의 문서를 복구해 사이트를 개설했습니다. 이 기록들은 야누코비치의 비리 의혹을 확인해주는 중요한 자료입니다.
So our journalists just pick those up from the water, you know, and dry them and scan them and, you know, then OCR them and put them online. But that was done with the help of our hackers. So we work with civic hackers, with programmers. So this is how it all started. But you know, this is an ongoing project. But now the hard part follows. You know, that means analyzing the documents and finding, because those documents mention lots of companies that were used in all sorts of weird ways. You know, and in money laundering and in siphoning money for the president's family and so on.
조직 범죄와 정부나 기업의 부패는 갈수록 글로벌화하고 있습니다. 따라서 OCCRP도 동유럽과 중앙아시아를 넘어 전 세계 언론인과 협업하고 있습니다.
We helped Egyptian investigative reporters right after the Arab Spring. They were trying to track down the money of the former president and his right-hand man, this person called Hussein Salem. And we helped them and we tracked down, you know, the company. So this guy Hussein Salem fled Egypt and he stole about $5 billion from Egypt. And together with our Egyptian colleagues, we unraveled all this, you know, scheme and, you know, lots of companies. It turned out some of the money, you know, was invested here in Bucharest, in the outskirts of Bucharest, being invested in a shopping mall. Some of the money were invested in Azerbaijan, some in Albania, and so on and so on. So we were able to track this down. As a result of that, these people were convicted back in Egypt. So Hussein Saleh, his daughter, his son, you know, and of course together with the ex-president Hosni Mubarak.
지난 2006년 푸틴 정부를 비판하는 기사를 썼다가 암살된 러시아 탐사 기자 안나 폴리트코프스카야. 그녀가 속했던 일간지 노바야 가제타도 현재 OCCRP 회원사입니다. 이렇듯 조직 범죄와 부패를 파헤치는 기자들은 때론 목숨까지 걸어야 합니다.
Our strength is that we are operating in a network. It's a cross-border network. So whenever I would go to approach a criminal somewhere, you know, to interview him or her, what I say, the first thing I say is, I'm part of the Organized Crime and Corruption Reporting Project, and the information that I have is with other members of the network outside of this country, in that, in there, in there, in there. So that the people, you know, that you're interviewing realize, you know, that even if they harm you, the information will still be out. I mentioned before the investigations in Azerbaijan about the family of the president. And our reporter there, Khadija Ismailova, she's an amazing reporter, you know, and she had to suffer, you know, because of that reporting. There was a video camera, a hidden camera, installed in her bedroom for quite a few months. And she was filmed, you know, in very intimate moments. And then the video was posted on the internet. So these sort of things happen, you know, and some of our people are threatened, you know, and all that. And we're trying to deal with this as quickly as possible. Whenever we hear that someone is threatened, we either pull the guy from the country, you know, and we move him to a different country. I believe investigative reporting can contribute to stopping these people that are engaged in organized crime and corruption from doing business as usual. Now, of course, we need other layers of the society to work with us in order to stop, you know, in a big way, the organized crime and corruption. Because what we do is we expose the things. And then it's up to the activists to take the causes, you know, to the politicians, to law enforcement, to whoever. So. 그래서 I mean, of course, you still have some good shows, you still have some good people, you know, that make TV. But overall, it's not a good thing that they're doing, you know. So what the investigative reporting centers do is they fill in for that need, you know. They keep their connections to the public a little bit more and, you know, via social networks and so on and so on. So.
OCCRP는 탐사 취재한 비리와 부패 구조를 수용자들에게 더 쉽게 전달하기 위해 다양한 플랫폼을 활용하는 노력도 펼치고 있습니다. 그중 하나가 비주얼 탐사 시나리오입니다.
We're also involved in developing technology for investigative reporting. So we created this tool called Visual Investigative Scenarios, which allows every investigative reporter in the world to visualize networks without having programming skills. So we developed this software that is really easy to use, you know, because, and this is also what's changed with the investigative reporting, is when you investigate organized crime, you always end up with lots of names of persons, lots of names of companies, lots of connections, and so on. And putting all those in a narrative is boring. I mean, people will not read like half a page of names, like this company is owned by this company, by this company, by this company. But you can supplement that with a visual. You know, so we created this tool where you can export your visuals as an iframe into, you know, with the connections, with all the names. So,
권력에 굴하지 않는 정신, 진실을 위해서라면 어떠한 위험도 마다하지 않는 용기. OCCRP가 세계적으로 주목받는 탐사 보도 조직으로 성장할 수 있게 된 원동력입니다. 탐사 보도는 언론이 가질 수 있는 최고의 무기라고 말하는 OCCRP. 이들의 탐사 보도는 동유럽과 구소련권의 구조적 부정부패를 폭로하고 문제를 사전에 예방하는 기능까지 수행하면서 사회의 긍정적 변화를 이끌어내고 있습니다.
We are the only ones, you know, able right now, capable to exchange information across borders in a very quickly, and we are the only ones that can be very efficient. Because of course, when you look at the law enforcement, you'll see all these bilateral treaties and international treaties. And while for investigative reporters, if you ask me to deliver you some information, you know, I can do it very quickly, you know, and we can both have a story. So I think this is why, you know, investigative reporting is very, very important because it fulfills a function in the society. We are investigating what the law enforcement is not investigating. And obviously, in some countries, you have very corrupt environments, and then there's a need for investigative reporters, you know, to investigate what the law enforcement is not investigating because they're corrupt and they're shutting their eyes or, you know, turning their heads from certain crimes or their part in it. So, I mean, it's just a very necessary power, you know, in the investigative power in a country and in a region and in the world.
뉴스타파 이유정입니다.